This DAP is on menopause. By the end of this DAP, you should understand what is menopause and its associated symptoms, and learn the various interventions and treatment for these symptoms. Specific topics like osteoporosis and hormone replacement therapy will be covered in their respective DAPs. Menopause is the permanent cessation of menstruation resulting from the loss of ovarian follicular activity. It is recognized to have occurred after 12 consecutive months of amenorrhea and is also termed the final menstrual marker. There is no biological marker to diagnose menopause. Perimenopause is the time immediately prior to and the first year after menopause. It is during this period when the endocrinological, biological, and clinical features of approaching menopause commence. There are various factors which determine the age of menopause. The median age of menopause is 50 years old, but ranges from 45 to 55 years worldwide. Premature menopause is natural or induced menopause occurring less than or equal to 40 years of age. This can be due to surgical or medical factors such as oophorectomy, ovarian irradiation, chemotherapy or hysterectomy, familiar and genetic factors such as ER-alpha polymorphism and twinning, and cigarette smoking. However, one must take note that premature ovarian failure leading to permanent or transient amenorrhea under the age of 40 is not considered a form of premature menopause. Factors causing a later age of menopause include a later age of menarche, a longer menstrual cycle length, increased parity, and oral contraceptive usage. How does menopause occur? The current theory is that menopause results from loss of ovarian follicular activity, in other words, reproductive aging. Women are born with 1.2 million follicles, decreasing to 1,000 follicles by menopause. Most of this loss is due to atresia, not ovulation. Atresia accelerates at around age 35 to 38. The perimenopausal period encompasses many changes. Physiological changes include erratic ovulation and fluctuating estrogen and progesterone levels. These can result in dysfunctional uterine bleeding and hormonal symptoms. Menopausal symptoms can be hormonal or non-hormonal. Hormonal symptoms include vasomotor symptoms such as hot flushes and night sweat, vagina thinning causing atrophic vaginitis, resulting in painful intercourse and increasing the risk of vagina infections, as well as aches and pains causing joint pain and stiffness. Other symptoms that are unrelated to hormonal changes include mood-related changes, cognitive disturbances, fatigue, urinary symptoms, vertigo and headache, palpitations, and sexual dysfunction. The management of menopausal symptoms include lifestyle modifications, non-prescription remedies or complementary and alternative medication, and pharmacotherapy. Lifestyle modification involves maintaining a healthy weight through diet and exercise, smoking cessation, reducing alcohol consumption, and relaxation techniques. In addition, there are many types of non-prescription herbal remedies. Some examples include isoflavone supplements, soya products, black cohosh, evening primrose oil, and ginkgo nuts. Complementary approaches include acupuncture, aromatherapy, reflexology, and homeopathy. Pharmacotherapy can be non-hormonal or hormonal prescription medications. Examples of non-hormonal medications include gabapentin, clonidine, and selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors such as venlafaxine and paroxetine. Hormonal therapy usually consists of a combination of estrogen and progesterone. How does one decide on which management is most suitable for a patient? In managing a patient's symptoms, one must always consider the patient's preferences and values, as well as their age group, length of menopause, and other risk factors. The patient may have various reasons for wanting treatment, including improving quality of life, increased longevity, to lower the risk of disease, or to relieve symptoms. This is a decision tree for patients with menopausal vasomotor symptoms. As you can see, hormonal therapy is not frequently recommended, and is only reserved for patients that are less than 60 years of age, with less than 10 years of menopause, who are at low risk of breast cancer or cardiovascular disease. For all other patients that are high risk and elderly, lifestyle modification, herbal remedies, CAM, and non-hormonal medications are the preferred choice. Treatment of vagina thinning and dryness consists mainly of lubricants and moisturizers. Hormonal treatment in the form of a low-dose vagina estrogen therapy can be used in patients with no history of breast cancer. This is the end of the VAP. Further reading references are as stated.